Hey guys, Professor Bill, Comic Book University, and Domino, issue number 5. That's right, history is made. This is the first time an issue of Domino has ever gone to number 5. So they actually mentioned that in the book also, which I'm like, yes, good, they noticed also. Master Shang-Chi teaches Domino a really cool way to get her powers to work, and that is that everything's got to be guided by her emotions, and fear can take away her power and all sorts of different things like that. So just calmly doing what she knows to do and just ignoring it and letting her powers manifest on their own is the way to make them work, regardless of what anybody else is going to do to her, any manipulators or whatever. So one of the coolest things that I've seen in a while, all right, especially with Domino, is that she just walks over and makes a little, you know, thing of water with the twist of lime in it or something like that, you know? And in the process of doing that, all of these people who go to attack her, they just tear themselves apart. They just get so busted up at one. Oh, man, it's funny. It's a scene where you just got to see it. At the end of the day, this is a really fun comic book. I definitely enjoyed the heck out of this. You know what I'm saying? A whole lot of fun. I am going to mention something that did bother me just a little bit, okay? First off, it's cool that Gail Simone goes and makes a mention of, hey man, you know, make sure that you listen to your best kung fu tracks while you're reading this comic book. No, I felt like this needed more of a Matrix-y sound. And I don't mean the soundtrack. I mean more of the what's that called? Not the soundtrack, the background noise, the score. There you go, the score. By the way, I might as well do this, duh. Gail Simone writing, Michael Shelfer, the guest artist, the layouts, David Baldion, Jesus Albertev, the colors, VC's Clayton Cowles, letters, Greg Land, Jay Leiston, and Frank DiArmada did the covers, the cover. So Jesus and Gail Simone both decide to leave a Spotify playlist, which I think is, you know, kind of fun, until I realized one very important note. Kiss, Domino. Where was that? Domino by the band Kiss. You know what I'm saying? The Kiss Army. Where's that song on this playlist? How do you have a playlist for Domino without that song? And I'm just saying, I think that would have gone better than most of these songs in here. I'm just pointing that out, man. I mean, there's some good songs in here, but not for, like, you know, this. Well, I don't know. Jesus was probably a little bit better in this regard. Anyway, I don't care. The point is, this was a really good comic book. I enjoyed it. And I guess one of my favorites is just all the hot chicks who are, like, dressing up as Domino. I totally dig that. Like, it just, for me, I love cosplay. I love cosplay regardless. It's also especially good with all the women who are doing it are good looking. Regardless, yes, fantastic comic book. I like that so many people are into this. This is fun. This is a fun read. I really don't know what else to say about that. To sell this comic book, literally, you just want to let everything go and just have fun with a good read. There was not high adventure in here. The only really cool thing that happened was that Domino was able to overcome the all the outside noise that was messing with her. And then we get to see what happened to the other guy. We also get to see, and I can't remember the guy's name, but the bad guy who's either he's doing well or she's doing well. Well, now that she can actually fully control that, that's cool. But now he's fully screwed up. And now that we know his story, that's kind of a sad part. That's a sad part. So mind you, it's good lot of fun in this, but somebody's genuinely getting screwed over. Like, he's evil, but how would any of us be if we were just constantly, hey, the better she feels, the worse I feel. Literally. Like, feelings. So, yeah. Yeah, that's kind of sad. I really hope this has a good ending for this character, at least. I imagine this is going to be wrapped up in the next issue. They usually use arcs in Marvel and DC for 6 issues long. So, hopefully something good happens for this guy. Honestly. Anyway, guys, I'm going to let this one go. Professor Bill, Comic Book University. Class dismissed.